In this video, we are going to prove that cos of A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Now consider one unit circle. Unit circle means it's a circle having radius 1 unit. So this is 1 unit radius. Center of the circle I am considering at origin. So this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Now the point somewhere here, say that point is P. You can even write its coordinates, and the coordinates will be 1, 0 for the point P. Now I am considering one point on the circle, say A, somewhere here, which I join with origin, center of the circle. And angle made by OA with this positive direction of x-axis, let that angle be A. This angle is A. Now, if the angle is A, then you can write the coordinates of this point as cos A, sin A. Theoretically, the point can be written as R cos theta, R sin theta, where theta is an angle made by radius with positive direction of x-axis and R is the radius value. So here, since I'm considering it is a unit circle, so length OA is 1 unit. So I got it as cos A, sin. I'm considering one more point on the circle, and that point, if I join with center of the circle, I'm getting OB. Angle made by OB with positive direction of x-axis is B. Then the point B can be written as cos B, sin B. Now, if you understand this diagram, then you can easily say that the angle made by AB at origin, or you can say angle AOB. What is angle AOB? It is angle A minus angle B. So that angle is A minus B. So angle AOB means this angle is A minus B. By the way, just try to understand. I can show you one more radius which is making angle A minus B with the positive direction of x-axis, and that point somewhere here it will be. So this is point C. Now the angle made by OC with positive direction of x-axis will be A minus B. So I can say from the diagram angle COP. This angle is also A minus B. Now, if you observe this diagram carefully, see both these angles are same. Which two angles? Angle AOB and angle COP. So, if you observe AOB and COP, both are sectors of the same circle and they are having same angle subtended at the center. Then in that case, the chord length AB is same as chord length CP because they are subtending same angle at the center and they are sectors of the same circle. So the radius length is also same. Now I have to equate just length AB and length CP. For that purpose, I have to apply the distance formula. Now question comes, what are the coordinates of C? So the way we write A and B, C can be considered as cos of A minus B, sine of A minus B. This is what point C is. Now, if we apply distance formula for getting length AB and length CP, then for length AB, it can be written as cos A minus cos B, the whole square, plus sine A minus sine B, the whole square. So this is what the left hand side, length AB according to distance formula. Now, what should I write for the length CP? Again, you are applying distance formula only, and it can be written as cos of A minus B minus 1 the whole square. See, why minus 1? Because this point P has x coordinate simply 1. While you can directly write sine A minus B minus 0 is sine A minus B. So you got it as sine square A minus B. So this is simply sine square A minus B. Now, I'm squaring both sides of this equation. So after squaring, left hand side becomes, now for left hand side, you can even expand the brackets with the help of A minus B the whole square formula. And then it becomes cos square A minus 2 cos A cos B plus cos square B plus sine square A minus 2 sine A sine B plus sine square B is equal to. Now what I'll get on right hand side? See, after squaring, this root will get removed. And again, you have to expand this first bracket by A minus B the whole square form. So it becomes cos square A minus B minus 2 cos A minus B plus 1 plus sine square A minus B. This is what I have. Now, just observe, this is cos square A plus sine square A. That is 1. As well as if you observe, there is cos square B plus sine square B, again 1. So that means in left hand side, you can write it as cos square A plus sine square A 1, cos square B plus sine square B 1, 1 plus 1 is 2 minus. Now from these two terms, I can have minus 2 common, and in bracket we got cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. While on the right hand side, now if you observe, there is again cos square theta plus sine square theta form. This is cos square A minus B plus sine square A minus B 1. Added with this one, you got 2 minus 2 cos of A minus B. Now in next step, you can cancel this 2 with this 2. And what you have is minus 2 times cos A cos B plus sine A sine B is equal to minus 2 times cos of A minus B. Now what we can do next? I think if we can cancel, everybody understood this now, we can cancel this minus 2 also. And I got the expression, that is cos of A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. So this is the required result.